Hey guys, Chris from Harmony Turbines here, and we're with our two electronics engineers, Jashwant and Sri.
Hello everyone.
So I think this is your first video, isn't it, Sri? Are you nervous?
Yeah.
A little bit?
A little bit.
It's okay. So what do you guys have going on here? We've been working on a lot of stuff lately. Tell me briefly what this is that we're working on here.
First thing, I'm going to talk about the furling control.
Okay.
Previously, we have a furling control, like either opening, fully opening or fully close, and using only by using button. Now we can control the furling from our PC remotely, like partial furling.
Okay. And like, I think this was Sri's handiwork here, right?
Yeah.
She was the brains behind this new algorithm. So do you want to show what we're talking about, guys? So before, we were basically opening and closing fully. We have always been talking about, in certain wind conditions, we would only want to close maybe 10% or 20%. So I asked these guys, I tasked them with finding a way that we could very simply give commands, close 10%, close 20%. And we can even zoom in, because those are the commands you type. So we can zoom in and show that, and then see the results of that in real time here. We're also not using the button anymore. Now we just use an interface, which is moving into the intelligent controls that are going to be put on here.
I'm going to opening like 50%.
So all of our commands are given in close, because we're either fully open or some portion of closed. So he typed in closed 50% there, which is essentially opening it halfway.
And closing back.
Yep. So we've moved into a very elegant design here now, where we're able to very intelligently say to our controller what we want to do and have it actually make sense. So in a high wind condition, where we finally need to start furling in, we might say close 10%, and then we might close 15%, then we might close 20%. So we will progressively close to whatever we need, and we'll be able to see exactly where we're at with the turbine, and we don't have to do mathematics and guess and, you know, 50,000 turns to get fully closed to fully open. All of that goes away.
And we can control the speed by RPM now.
Yep.
And in the future, we're gonna, by using the wind speed detection, the furling will be automatically controlling instead of manually. The microcontroller will do it automatically.
Yep. So I think Sri's in charge of that too. All of the important stuff for the furling itself and controlling those algorithms. We give her all the important stuff now, since, you know, of these two, she's the one who definitely, no, I'm joking. They're both awesome, guys. And this really moves us into where we need to be as we move forward. Now, I think you guys wanted to show something on the full-size turbine. Yeah. We're gonna pause the video and go over there.
Yeah.
All right, guys, so we're over here now in our tent where we monitor the conditions on the roof. And Sri has done some really cool work with, what is this little guy?
Yeah, we have designed LCD where we can see RPM and wind speed through turbines.
So we have real-time monitoring of our wind speed and our RPMs. We don't have to go into the database and look back at historical logs in the database.
Now the wind speed is 2.1. It will be showing as the wind moves. It will be changing continuously. And we have made zero-crossing detectors also.
Basically, the zero-crossing detectors help us to clean up our waves.
Winds.
So when we have the sine wave coming from our generator, this helps to clean that signal up.
Small correction,
Chris. Yeah, go ahead.
Actually, the zero crossing detection, it will detect the zero crossing path, like detecting the peaks, so that we can monitor the frequency. By using frequency, we can monitor the RPM using a simple formula.
Okay.
And regarding the filtering from sine wave to pure DC, from AC to DC, we have designed this input side filtering board, which will act like a filtering, like a rectification part with some protection kind of thing. Previously, we have done this through whole board, but it doesn't have any protection part. It does only like a rectification. So right now we improved the design. Like over here, we used to get like pulsated DC instead of pure DC, but over here now we have like pure DC. This is like improved protection, and these are our dump load resistors. And this is our new LTC bug boost controller boot. In the future, we're gonna interface this one with our microcontroller for MPPT control.
All right, so the kindergarten version of what these guys just said here is basically we're moving to the much more intelligent electronics with our STM32 board. We now have an incoming, the ability to filter and have dump loads. We have our initial inrush of current that we're able to filter out and have across our four different capacitors here. We're getting into basically more robust, more production-ready components. And that progression is kind of what you see here, where we're going from one version to the next to the next. And then finally, we wanted to show up on the roof the ability to do the same stuff that we were doing down here live. So Sri, let's say we wanted to close 40%. So we issue a close 40 command and boom, the turbine is closing 40%. And then if we wanted to close the whole way, then it'll close the rest of the way. So it's at a funny angle right now. It's a little bit difficult to see, but there it goes. And then if we just do open, we're opening back up. So all these commands and everything they're doing, the work that they're doing down here on the ground is obviously translating to the unit on the roof as well. And we're just demonstrating that here for you live. All right, guys, really, really cool work. In the future, as we move forward, we're going to be having a power supply up there on the roof so that all of these controls are able to basically function off of the live power that we're making from the turbine. In the case where there's no wind, then it will just go into sleep mode. And I think you guys said, yeah. How much does that draw when it's in sleep mode?
Some microamps.
Okay.
3 to 4 microamps.
All right. So basically, it will have almost no effect at all on your back end battery bank because it'll just be in sleep mode waiting for wind until it wakes back up. So that's the other thing that I wanted here. I didn't want this to be a drain on the resources as it was just sitting there waiting for good wind. So, okay, awesome. All right, guys, Chris, Jeshwant, and Sri from Harmony Turbine saying thank you very much for being with us, for following along, for understanding this journey is not a simple one. We're having to build a lot of these things from scratch because they're either terrible for a solution that's maybe close to what we're after, either terrible or no solutions at all that are out there. So we're having to create from scratch the systems that are gonna work harmoniously, see how I did that, with our product and be able to deliver in the end something that you're gonna be happy with, you're gonna be understanding it will be reliable, it'll make the power you're after and give you the results that you want in the end. So that's what we're all about here at Harmony Turbines, trying to pull all that together into one cohesive product that you can really be happy with. So thank you, take care, until next time, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.